Dear students, in previous slides we have discussed the acid and their types. Here in the next class, that is a base. So base is a substance which is sour in taste and soapy in touch. And as far as their types are concerned, here we can divide the base into two categories. That is weak base and strong base. Weak base are those naturally substances which contain less hydrogen ion. Weak base are those substances which is naturally produced substance and contain less hydroxide ion, as for example magnesium hydroxide, MgOH2. This is magnesium hydroxide. So this is the weak base. Second, that is strong base, are having more number of hydroxide ions. Here it is less number of hydroxide ions, here it contains more number of hydroxide ion in the solution. And example, that is sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide. Now we have discussed that acid, base, and some substances are acidic in nature, some substances are basic in nature, but there are also some substances which is neither acid nor base. They are called neutral substances. The substance which is neither acidic in nature or nor basic in nature, they are called neutral substances. And these neutral substances, for example water, when we take water, when we drink water, we have no taste, neither it is acid nor base. So water is a neutral substance. Any substance in which you do not find any taste, that is neutral substance. And that substance are indicated by the pH scale. pH scale, as we have seen the pH paper, litmus paper, that indicates the substance whether it is acidic or basic in nature. That is same like we have the pH paper. So by this pH paper, where the numbers are indicated, so if the value of pH is less than 7, then that substance is acidic in nature. So if we take the pH paper and put into the acid, their value will be less than 7. As much as the value decreases, it indicates the strongness of the acid. As much as strong acid we have, their pH value will be less. And second, that is the substance which has more than pH value 7. If the pH value is more than 7, that substance is base. It means more than 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. If we increase the substances towards from 7 to 8 to 9 to 10, then that substance becomes more basic. And a substance which has the pH value just 7, at 7, so that substance is called neutral substance. As for example water, if you take the pH paper and put into the water, then their value will indicate 7. So that is the pH paper. Now again I am going to the indicator. Indicator is a special chemicals that changes its color to indicate the presence of a chemical substances, which indicates the presence of the chemical substances, which tell us the nature of substances, whether the substance is acidic or basic in nature. So such substances are known as indicator. So indicator are those substances which indicates or tell us about the nature of the substances, whether the substance is acid or basic in nature. Then again, the types of the indicator, the first, that is litmus, turmeric, China rose and red cabbage. All these are natural indicator which is found in the nature. This litmus is obtained from the lichen. Okay, the lichen is a substance which is produced from the algae and fungi. So this is the litmus paper, earlier we have discussed. Then second, turmeric, which we call haldi in our house. So this turmeric powder or a solution, it turns yellow in neutral substance and acidic substance. When you put the turmeric in the neutral substance like water or in acid, it turns yellow, and it turns red into the base. When you put turmeric powder in the base, it turns red. Likewise, we have China rose. This China rose turns pink into the acid and green into the base. When a China rose solution or the liquid is put into the acid, it turns pink. And when a China rose solution or the powder put into the base, it turns green. Likewise, we have red cabbage. This red cabbage turns red into the acid and green into the base. So this is the natural indicator. That is the litmus, turmeric, China rose and the red cabbage. Second, that is we have the chemical indicator or synthetic indicator which we prepared in the laboratory or which you get from the market. The first, that is a methyl orange. This methyl orange turns pink red in the acidic solution. When we put the methyl orange in the acid, it turns pink red. And when we put methyl orange in the base, it turns yellow. Same as in case of the phenolphthalein. This is the second chemical, phenolphthalein, which is the chemical indicator. This methyl orange is also chemical indicator. And this phenolphthalein is also chemical indicator. This chemical indicator becomes colorless in the acidic solution. When you put phenolphthalein in the acid, it does not change its color, means it changes into the colorless. And second, if you put phenolphthalein in the basic solution, it turns pink. So this indicates the substance whether it is acidic or basic in nature. Here this substance also indicates whether the substance is acid or basic in nature. So these are the indicators. This is a natural indicator and this is chemical indicator. Now we will discuss about the neutralization process in our everyday life. When we feel some acidity in our body, we feel pain in our stomach, at that time we take some antacid like diazine or ENO. When we take diazine or ENO, which is a base, this diazine or ENO, when we take in our body, we get relaxed. So when we feel acidity or indigestion, then we take the antacid like diazine or the ENO to neutralize the effect of acid in our body. Second, that is the use of neutralization process in our daily life, that is ant sting. When any ant bite us, they release acid into our body. That acid is the formic acid. And when this acid enters to our body into the skin, it causes burning, it causes pain. So at that time we apply the base, that is calamine solution or any hydroxide solution to that place, and that skin becomes neutral and we get relief from the pain. Third, use of the neutralization process in our daily life, that is soil treatment. Sometimes we have different kinds of the soil becomes acidic. If we have to remove the acidic property of the soil, then we have to add the base into the soil, like calcium hydroxide or quake lime, slack lime into the soil, so that the soil becomes neutral. And after the soil becomes neutral, then we can grow the different kinds of the crop here. So this is all about the use of the base, types of the base, and the use of the neutralization process in our daily life. Thank you.